We're going to show you how to correctly assemble your new Corneo Sport 500 outdoor table tennis table. The principles used on this table apply to most other Corneo tables. Make sure you have two people to put it together. The whole process should take about an hour. You will need the following tools: one 13mm combination spanner, one 10mm combination spanner, one 13mm socket, one 10mm socket, one number 2 posi drive screwdriver, and one number 3 posi drive screwdriver. First, lay the box flat and open the box using the quick tear strips. Lay out all the components that are immediately visible and organise them tidily. The fixings are in separate bags with the part numbers stamped on the outside. You can use two parts of the wood that comes in the box as protection to lay the tables down on. Discard the other offcuts, as these are just to protect the table in transit. Be careful when taking the tops out of the box. Two people should lift the top at the same time straight up. The top could get marked if it catches the other one. Move them away from the assembly area again, being careful not to rub them against each other. Let's start putting the table together. Remember, it is important to follow every step of the printed instructions supplied with your table to make sure your table is put together properly and safely. Step 1. The first thing to put together is the undercarriage. You will need these parts. Insert the 1033 bolt through the centre of one wheel, passing through the bracket attached to the 7065.D bar and through the second wheel. Secure this with the 1121 Nylock nut and tighten sufficiently to still allow the wheels to move. These two components are the only two in the assembly using a 13mm socket or spanner. The nylon nuts have a nylon insert in which the bolt cuts a thread. This is to prevent the nut from coming loose in use. Repeat this process for the second wheel assembly, then again for the second 7065.D bar. Use the 2204 bar to attach the wheel brakes, taking care to ensure they are fitted the correct way round. Look for the pimples in the black wheel bracket, already fixed to the 7065D bar. These need to match up with the holes in the red 4465 pedal. The larger side of the pedal is adjacent to the bracket. Step 2. Now we add the crossbar and side panels. The side panel, transport handle bracket, only used on the Sport 500, and crossbar are attached to the 7065.D bar in one step. Use the 1838 bolt and pass it through the 7898 bracket, then the side panel, and finally through the 7060B crossbar, and secure it with a 1120 Nylock nut. Repeat this for the other bolt on this side of the side panel, then repeat again to attach the second side panel. Note the transport handle can go on either side of the table. It's important that the 1838 and 1120 are fully tightened at this stage. The third step is to add the bat holders, which are fitted either side of the side panel. Put the bat holder into the slot in the side panel. Use the 1843 bolt to attach the 4472 bat holder to the 7065D bar and tighten fully with a 1140 nut. Repeat for the other three bat holders. Step 4. Next, we assemble the supporting bars that connect the tabletop to the undercarriage. In the previous step, we used bolt 1843 to attach the bat holders. We now need to attach the support arms to this same bolt. First, attach the 7062 bar, the shorter one, making sure it's forming a downwards arc. Now add the 1292 spacer, followed by the long bar, part number 7895, which will form an upwards arc. Secure these parts using the 1120 Nylock nuts. They should still be allowed some movement. Now repeat this process 3 times for the other supporting bars. Step 5. It's important that 2 people perform this step as it involves locating the tops into the side panels. First, you need to retract the locks on one tabletop. This is done by lifting the red handle and inserting the 2343 pin into the exposed hole. Lift the tabletop and move towards the partially assembled table. The black locks that protrude from the frame need to be put into the round hole inside the side panel. Once both sides have been slotted into place, slowly slide the top down into the bottom of the side panel and lift the top so that it's vertical. One person should remain supporting the tabletop whilst the other person attaches the supporting bars. The 1830 bolt should be passed through the frame of the top using the 1296 spacer through the pre-drilled hole in the 7062 support bar and secured using a 1120 Nylock nut. To locate and tighten the 1830 bolt, it may be necessary to tilt the top slightly. Repeat this on the same top at the other side of the table. Now remove the 2343 pin, which was holding the locks open, so that it can be reused on the other tabletop. This top is now secure, and you can repeat the process for the other table half. Step 6. Some of our table comes with the legs already assembled. On this model, we need to attach the legs. The legs should be assembled one at a time. Take 14469D and pair it with a 4469G so that they face each other. The 4479 leg leveller is screwed on in a clockwise direction and this will hold the structure together. Now take 17894 and attach it to the outside of the 4469G using the 1844 bolt going through the middle hole. Add the 7893 bar to the leg assembly next to the 4469D and ensure the 1844 bolt passes through all the components. Finger tightening using the 1140 nut on the end of the 1844 bolt. The leg assembly will now be held in place while you use the 1900 bolt through the top and bottom holes. Note the 1900 is a self-threading screw. Now fully tighten the 1140 nut on the end of the 1844 bolt. Repeat this step for a second leg assembly. Note that bolt 1844 must always be on the inside of the table. All other fixings remain the same. Repeat this step for the other pair of leg assemblies. Step 7. It's now time to attach the legs to the other supporting bar. Pass the 1844 bolt that protrudes from the middle of the leg through the 7895.A supporting bar and secure using the 1120 nut. Repeat this step for the other 3 leg assemblies. Step 8. Now that the leg assemblies are attached to the supporting bars, we need to fix them to the crossbar that stretches across underneath of the playing surface. Raise the leg assembly up to meet the underside of the table and secure it to the tabletop by passing a 1830 bolt through the top of the hole in the crossbar. This operation may require tilting the top towards you to achieve perfect alignment. On this table, one pre-drilled hole in the crossbar that is factory fitted is not used. Repeat this for the other leg support, then repeat this process for the other 3 leg assemblies. Step 9. Let's attach the net post assembly, which on this table is the retractable design. Position part 4468 so that it is tipped inwards between the playing surfaces and rests on the bar sighted at the top of the side panel. Use the 1402 screw to attach part 4485 to the base of the net post assembly and secure it in position. Repeat this on the other side of the table. Step 10. For this step, make sure the table is in the open position. The net post bracket will be upright. You'll need the remaining contents of the 2817 net post assembly pack too. Pull out the 4561 pin from the 4568 section, then pass it through the seam at the side of the net. Slide the 4561 net pin into the 4586 upright section of the net post assembly until the cap is level with the top of the upright. Secure the plastic tab on the notched section on the side of the 4586 upright. This is how the tension is adjusted. Stretch the net across the table and repeat that step at the other side. You can use the 4538 red adjustment screw to change the height of the net. Step 11. We just have to add the finishing touches. These accessories are not available on all models, so just do the steps that are right for your table. We are now going to fit the back covers that go alongside the side panel. They simply click into place. Fit all four in the same way. Step 12. The Sport 500 is the only table with a transport handle. This allows it to be easily lifted over things like steps and doorways. It's only meant for lifting the table, rather than pulling it along. Fit the 7897 handle onto the 7898 bracket fitted to the side panel earlier in step 2. Secure it by passing the 1708 bolts through the bracket and into the handle, then use the 1120 nuts to fasten this. Step 13. There is a cover plate that should be fitted to hide the bracket used for the transport handle. Place the cover plate over the bracket at the base of the handle and secure it using the 1404 screws. Step 14. Some Corneo tables have corner protection pads. To fit these, line the lugs up on the inside of the protection pad with the slots cut into the edges of the frame, then simply push upwards. The corner protection pads will click into place. Now use the 1374 screw through the base of the corner protector to hold this in place. Step 15 and 16. The Sport 500 and Proline 510 also benefit from ball dispensers, part number 4475. For outdoor tables, remove the backing paper off the self-adhesive strip. Locate the lug into the slot on the underside of the frame and pivot the ball holder upwards until contact is made with the underside of the playing surface. Press firmly. The ball dispensers are positioned in the left-hand corner on the underside of the playing surface. The fitting of the ball dispensers is slightly different for indoor and outdoor tables. Opening and closing. Corneo use two principal opening and closing systems. Tables fitted with the DSI system have a red handle located in the middle of the table on the underside. By pulling this red handle, the locks are released to enable the table to open and close. When opening the table, you will need to pull the red handle once to lower the table part way, then again to fully lower the table half. This is because tables which have the DSI system have 16 locking points, and this prevents the tabletop from being lowered in one step to reduce the risk of injury. Check the locks are engaged. You should hear them click into place. And, if necessary, raise the tops manually from each side of the net. With the push and lock system, unlock the tops by pressing the red buttons at the bottom of the side panels, level with the wheels, on both sides of the table. Carefully lower the top until it is in the playing position. Check the locks are engaged. You should hear them click into place. And, if necessary, raise the tops manually from each side of the net. Maintenance. To maintain the condition of the playing surface, we recommend using our regenerative cleaner. Do not use aggressive products such as abrasives, solvents, or acids. We also recommend using a Corneo cover on outdoor tables to prevent them from being damaged or getting dirty. It will also help to protect the outdoor tops against color alteration caused by long exposure to sun rays. All fixings should be checked periodically to ensure they have not become loose in use. In normal use, it is possible for the locking system to require maintenance, and the instructions for this are included at the end of the assembly instructions. After sales. You should keep the instructions safe and refer to them during maintenance operations and when ordering spare parts from the parts list on the last page. The reference and serial number can be found on the underside of the tabletop in the top right-hand corner. Warranty. All Corneo tables are supplied with a 3-year warranty, 2 years on the Tectonic tables, and this is extended to 10 years on the outdoor playing surface, 3 years for the Tectonic. The warranty on the outdoor tabletops covers deformation, delamination, and erasing of the white lines. The warranty covers any parts broken due to a manufacturing defect, not misuse or normal wear and tear.